It'll be Free Palestine on YouTube. So, you know, this rally, basically.
تشريع تسوي فيها.
So look on YouTube, see Free Palestine video, Free Palestine.
Assalamu alaikum. First, let's really thank the youth and the young people who organized this rally. Or thinking about the frivolous things in life. So this is really their contribution for organizing us and bringing us in here. I'm speaking on behalf of the American Muslims for Palestine, the national organization, and I serve as the chair. Now, we are at a time where injustice, oppression, and insidious disregard for human life is being so prevalent that it gives you a gut feeling that there's something fundamentally wrong in the world that we live in. At a time where those who lie are celebrated, at a time where those who are robbing us blind in Wall Street are being thought of as smart investors, at a time where a president that invaded two countries is celebrated and thought of as a person that has reoriented American foreign policy, at a time where a professor who authorized and supported torture gets an endowed chair in the law school at UC Berkeley. At a time where young immigrants fleeing violence, oppression, and the dismantlement of their economies in Latin America, in North Africa, in Sub-Saharan Africa, are being thought as terrorists or a threat to our society, there is fundamental something wrong in the world that we live in. When we speak about the oppression taking place in Gaza, we need to think that every street that we were walking on, whether it's in San Francisco, in Detroit, in Latin America, in Mexico, in Venezuela, every street reminds us that is a part of Palestine, because we are all feeling the dispossession of the Palestinians. Now what we need to understand, what has taken place in Palestine. This is a colonial settler program. Settler colonialism is structured on genocide and dispossession of the indigenous population. We should not be deluded not to understand that the Americas had the most successful genocide settler colonial program. And as such, when we think of Palestine, we need to think of settler colonialism. It is commits genocide against the indigenous population because it does not want the people, it wants the land. A land without a people, or a people without a land, have to be brought into reality by means of genocide. For Palestine have always had a people from time immemorial. If you don't believe me, just read all the historical texts. Go through the archaeological evidence. Go about everything. Every time archaeologists dig down, a Canaanite came out standing to them saying, free Palestine. Free Palestine. Free Palestine. Israel says, and some of our people in Washington, and I know Washington is Israeli occupied territories, and that's why you hear them saying the same thing they say, because they're beholden to APAC. Israel says that it has the right to defend itself. Well, can't we ask the question, does the Palestinians have the right to defend themselves? Then why is it that the United States would not send them F-16? Why is that the United States would not give them tanks, armaments? But no, it supports the aggressors. It supports settler colonialism. It supports Israel at the expense of the Palestinians. And now we are here gathered in the UN Plaza. And I know the UN Plaza is symbolic, but the United Nations has become an instrument for U.S. foreign policy and for making the Israeli aggression something that international law is completely silent and deadly. So we need not only to critique UN structure, but we need to fundamentally change the relationship that governs the United Nations and international law, because international law has become an instrument for the powerful to maintain their advantage over the powerless, to maintain what they stole from those whom they stole with, completing and maintaining the dispossession by means of a civilized international code. So we need to challenge and critique this fundamentally, especially as we're speaking here in the UN Plaza. Now, others will speak about the three Israeli settlers that were taken as or kidnapped in the West Bank. And it is important for us to feel the suffering and pain of every human being. But when will be feeling the suffering of the Palestinian nation that has been kidnapped for the past 67 years? We as a nation have been kidnapped for 67 years, dispossessed of our cities, our village has been destroyed, our orchards been taken, our banks been taken, our cars, our vineyards, everything that has meaning to the Palestinians have been taken and held hostage, including books. Israel, one of those countries that actually took books, stole books from people's library, stole books from archives and taken into Tel Aviv University and Ben-Gurion University. This is the modern process of a genocide directed at the Palestinians. So we need to remind them that the whole been kidnapped. Speaking about President Obama. He only feels the pain of Israeli mothers. I'm saying to President Obama, stop answering for Netanyahu's phone call and look with the eyes of Martin Luther King at the world. You reach the White House on the backs of people who struggle from can't see in the morning to can't see at night. From those workers who strike on the shores, from the civil rights movement, from those who organize day in and day out for you to reach the White House, not to maintain it white, but actually to make it a house that would be representative of those who struggled to get you to that place. So when you pick up the phone, and only answer to Netanyahu, you'll be holding to the white man principle of settler colonialism, and we want you to keep it. That got you into the White House. Lastly, Israel is powerful militarily. It has powerful friends in important places. It had the corporate structure behind it, but it lacks the moral, ethical foundation and power. We have the ethical, moral power, and those who have the ethical and moral power will win. Palestine will be free. The arc of history is very long, but it tells our justice. And we're confident, we're sure, more sure than our standing here, that we will be back to Palestine. We will be back to Palestine to celebrate the collective victory that is not only from us in here, but internationally. Palestine today is the symbol for the world over, not because of the Palestinians, but in every person, there is the reflection of their feeling of dispossession, their feeling of weakness, their feeling there is something fundamentally wrong that has dispossessed them. And for that, we say the 99% of the world are for a free Palestine, and it is time that we all will witness free Palestine, and if not us, it will be our children. No make mistake about it. It is something that we all have to be sure and confident about, and hopefully, collectively, we will see and witness a free Palestine. Thank you. Assalamu
day by day. Palestinians to not live under occupation, to return to their homes as refugees, and not to live under second-class citizenship in Israel.
Yeah! We've got to start!
We support divestment not because it's the legal thing to do, but because it's the moral thing to do. Palestinians are humans, and they deserve their human rights, and we will not stop organizing until Palestine is free. So, to Israel, to the Israeli government, to everyone that's supporting the Zionist occupation, we say that this moment of crisis is an opportunity for us to organize in even stronger, even better numbers. And as these bombs continue to drop in Gaza, as the soldiers go into the ground, the people around the world will unite in their determination for the freedom of people in Palestine. Thank you.
We are the Punjabi Sikh Khalistani youth of the Bay Area. And we support the Palestinian struggle. We come from a revolutionary people. And we come from a history of overthrowing any oppressive state, whether that's Israel or the Indian government. Our people have been continuously persecuted and occupied by the Indian government and majority. This year marks the 30th anniversary of one of the most brutal genocides of the Sikh nation. And as we demand Khalistan, we demand Palestine. So let's demand the justice and free Palestine, because oppression is a human issue. Oppression is for all of us, so let's fight that oppression together. We are here today to support our brothers and sisters in their fight against injustice and a terrorist state. We know what it feels like to have your children burned alive and shot at point blank range. They have killed our children, they've raped our women, and they've torn down our homes, but they haven't torn down our spirit. We Punjabi Khalistani Sikh stand in solidarity with Palestinians and Palestinians. Long live Khalistan. So here, let's raise our fist and say Palestine Zindabad.
Palestine! Palestine!
Zindabad!
Khalistan!
Zindabad!
Ikram!
Zindabad!
Palestine!
Zindabad!
Palestine!
Zindabad!
We also say India out of Khalistan. So today, let's say Israel out of Palestine. Israel out of
Palestine!
Israel out of
Palestine!
Israel out of
Palestine!
Israel out of
Palestine!
Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa! Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh!
Hi everyone. I just got back from Palestine 2 weeks ago, and I can say that it's not getting better. The people are being treated like animals regardless of you if you have the Hawiya or you guys citizenship. We are treated like shit at the border for 6 hours, being interrogated and treated like criminals. Imagine going to your country being criminalized for being of Palestinian descent. As you drive from one city to another, the soldiers open the doors, look at you like you're animals, and demand citizenship. They are dehumanizing our people, regardless if you're American, regardless of your Palestinian, regardless of your anything other than Jewish descent. You will be treated like an animal in Palestine. I have watched Palestinian men and women be humiliated at checkpoints. I have watched children being stripped away from their parents' arms in Jerusalem. I had cousins' homes were raided that night, and all the Shabab were taken. The situation is not getting better. We cannot just sit down and watch as our people are being treated like criminals in their own country. In their own country, we are treated like we did something wrong. What have we done to these people? All we have done was become Palestinian. They are criminalizing us. This is not getting better. It is time for us to take a stand. The youth, we are the next generation that will free Palestine, inshallah. We will free Palestine. And it starts with being beautiful people.
support groups like AROC, ANSWER, PYM, Arab Youth Organization, and make a difference. We will make difference. We will make a change and for our people. Free, free Palestine!
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 And Israeli war crimes!
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 From PYM, the Palestinian Youth Movement, the International Earth Organization.
Put on your hands from Iraq and the Gaza to Afghanistan. Yeah! And its drones, and its occupations, and its wars, and its murders of people who we in this country are not even supposed to know the names of, this has to stop. I know everyone here understands what's true and what's right, but I ask you to join with us to go out to the people who are living in this country of all nationalities, all faiths or no faith, young and old, and say, look, your government is committing crimes by paying for and supporting the genocidal policies of Israel against the Palestinian people, and it's not going to stop as long as we wait for the people on top to stop it. It will only stop from below. That's us, all of us, together. The world can't wait. Stop the U.S. paying for this illegal, immoral, illegitimate occupation and this murderous war.
And what is happening in Palestine, what's happening in Sudan, this is it. This is the inheritance of something that the people never asked for. And so, being here, I want to say that Sudan stands in solidarity with the Palestinian people. We always have and we always will. And I think that one other thing is that being here as youth, this is like the most important thing we can do, because for, in the end, the next generation is really in our hands. We are the ones who are going to be occupying all of these spaces in society, and so we need to make sure that we do that with this consciousness that injustice we don't stand for. We don't stand for colonialism. We don't stand for racism. We don't stand for apartheid. We don't stand for institutionalized forms of oppression. And so that's why I'm here, and I'm here with the family, and here with all of you. So I just want to say that, and free Palestine, and free Sudan, and free all oppressed people, inshallah.
Coming out today, but as she was just saying, as Tom was just saying, we need Arab and we need youth. Like, literally, AL is probably only, what, 10 of us? I think we could fit in the backseat of our car. We need a lot more of you guys. You guys just don't show up to protest and that's it. We need to organize. We need to come out every damn day. So now I'm going to give the mic over to Linda, and she's going to read a list of the martyrs. We're going to have a moment of silence for the kids and the
Don't go to your country, even if it's not even your country, just go!
Exactly. They don't want people to know what they're doing. And it's up to us as Palestinian Americans, Arab Americans, African Americans, wherever you are, raise awareness because we have so much